The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be in the days of the Son of Man. They were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage up to the day that Noah entered the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. Similarly, as it was in the days of Lot, they were eating, drinking, buying, selling, planting, building. On the day when Lot left Sodom, fire and brimstone rained from the sky and destroyed them all. So it will be on the day of the Son of Man is revealed. On that day, someone who is on the housetop and whose belongings are in the house must not go down to get them. And likewise, one in the field must not return to what was left behind. Remember the wife of Lot. Whoever seeks to preserve his life will lose it, but whoever loses it will save it. I tell you, on that night, there will be two people in one bed. One will be taken, the other left. And there will be two women grinding meal together. One will be taken, the other left." They said to him in reply, "Where, Lord?" And he said to them, "Where the body is, there also the vultures will gather." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are meditating now on the end times, and we say that the end times does not mean one day. It means the final stage of God's plan. And in the fullness of time, the final stage of God's plan with regards to His creation and salvation of the world, it happened during the incarnation, or it started in the incarnation, when His Son became man in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and it will extend until His second coming. And therefore, we are now living in the end times. No more final stage. This is the final stage of God's kingdom. The age of the church, the age of the Holy Spirit, the age of invitation, the age of encouragement to live in faith and love and hope in God, and then final judgment. So we are living in the end times. How long? We do not know. Because 1,000 years may mean one day to the Lord, and one day may mean 1,000 years to the Lord. So the church was established to prepare the people for the fulfillment of the kingdom. Then we meditated on the kingdom. The kingdom is not geography, is not a place, so to say. It's a lifestyle. That's why when Jesus was asked, "Are you a king?" "I am a king. But my kingdom is not in this world." Because His kingdom is a lifestyle, a worldview, a lifestyle, a Christian lifestyle. So if you live a lifestyle, a Christian culture, you remain in the kingdom. If you do not live the lifestyle of Christ as Christians, you are outside His kingdom. My kingdom is among you. My kingdom is in your heart. So that's why wherever we are, as long as we are Christians, we belong to the kingdom of Christ. So that's our understanding of the kingdom. So ang simbahan wala nag-compete sa mga kingdoms in this world. Makonstruct siya sa iya castles, kaysa ang iyang boundaries. Kundi the Church of Christ thrives bisan diin nga parte sang ginharian kay. Posible Filipino ka, pero citizen ka man sang Kingdom of God, o American ka. citizen ka man sa kingdom of God. So, it covers. So, wala siya sang kompetensya kaysa pagkamatuod, bisan anong color mo, bisan anong culture mo, status mo sa kabuhi, administration, opposition, as long as you live with Christian values, you belong to the kingdom of Christ. So, bisan palasimba ikaw, kag wala ka sang Christian lifestyle, you do not belong to the kingdom of God. Because ang kingdom of God is expressed in our way of life. And this way of life is based on our relationship with God. Precisely, kung may relasyon kita sa Dios, nag-change atong lifestyle. Ang isa ka lalaki nga single sang una, lain ang iya schedule, lain ang pag-spend sang time, sang may asawa na siya, nagalain ang iya lifestyle, priority sa kabuhi. Amo man ang pagkapari, sang una, hindi pa siya pari, lain ang iya lifestyle, pero sang pari na siya, ang iya kabuhi, isa na sang isa kapari. Kristiyano, sang una, hindi siya Kristiyano, sang mabunyagan na siya ang iya lifestyle and values or the kingdom values. The way we celebrate our birthday, the way we bury our dead, the way we treat our enemies, pray for your enemies, pray for your persecutors, the way we handle business, the way we vote as Christians, the way we dress up, the way we use a language. These things, all aspects of our life, are influenced by our being Christians. Because we are no longer the citizens of the world only, we too are the citizens of heaven. So muna ang naminsang kingdom. Kontrahon kita, hambal ni Christ, the world will hate you, not because of you, but because of me. Tungod kontra nila ang aton Ginoong Jesucristo, automatic kontrahon kamo, kay hindi nila gusto ako siling sang Ginoo. So kung ikaw lang, hindi ka pag-hate, pero people will hate you because of Him. Damo ang nag-give up kay Christ, kay ginakadlawan sila. Ginhambalan sila nga backward. Ginhambalan sila nga mas superstitious. No. Nambalan na ni Jesus nga daan. Prepare. If you want to follow me, take up your cross and follow me. So muna ang price sang being followers of Christ in this world. Sometimes there are little consolations. But the consolation actually is not found here, the total consolation, but in the next life to come. Today, the gospel is taken from Luke 17. Kaya naghambal ini, again, sang kingdom. Siling niya, as it was in the days of Noah, so it will be the days of the Son of Man. They were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage up to the day that Noah entered the ark. Wala pakialam ang mga tao. Abi nila, hindi matapos ang kalibutan kag hindi sila mapatay. They drink, they marry, they eat, they plant, they build, as if they will live forever in this world. But not for you. May katapusan. Duha ang kahulugan sang end of the world. End of your personal world in death, and end of the world, general world, in the coming of Christ. The last judgment. That's why our world ends in the particular judgment, and we will be judged our particular world after death. But there will be a general judgment. It's the judgment of the whole world. Oftentimes we focus on general judgment as Christians. Ano matabo sa kalibutan? May Antichrist, malinog, may volcano, malupok. Kamuna, nagdumdum kita sang general, which is also good. But remember, prepare also for the personal judgment, for your death. Kaya sa ano na lang natabo sa politika, may amo kita sini, nagalam mo kita sini. dumduman ng imo kay basi buwas mapatay ka na. That's the end of your world. Kapanumdum ka parte sa kalibutan, way kaya ka kumpesar. Preparaha imo kaugalingon. Nami man na sa kalibutan manumdum, pero ti wala ada control. Nakaparticipate ka lang sa mga maayuda, pero in the end, parte ka lang da, wala ka da control. May nag-decide, sinaya ka, may nag-ano. Importante man ang imo end of the world sa imo kamatayon sa death. Mangkot siya. Tisan o ni matapos ang kalibutan? Hambal ni Jesus. Sa diin ni, matabo, sinabi ni Jesus, where the body is, there also the virtues will gather. Meaning, wala sang lugar. Basta may lawas, dira ang kamatayon. Dito ka man sa dalong tubig, basta may lawas. Dito ka man to sa babaw niyog, basta may lawas. Kundiin ang lawas, dito ang kamatayon. So preparar, kundiin ka. Hindi ito yung dito lang sa north, dito lang sa south. No. Kundiin ang lawas ng tao, dito man siya mapatay. Where the body is, there also the vultures will gather. So, preparar. Paano kita magpreparar para sa atong personal death? Well, good works, of course, arada sa Bible. Isa sa mga pagpreparar, good works of mercy. Of course, kaduha nga pagpreparar, sacraments. May sacramental life, gig kita. Okay? Good works ay aton na aksyon. Sacramental life, aksyon sang Dios sa imo. So, duha na. So, good works mo, kag-prayer. Imo na ya. Ikaw ang nag-struggle. Ikaw nag-work pagkanto sa Dios. Pero sacraments, kapungko ka malangda, dugay-dugay, pakalawaton tanak ka. Tiway ka man da ubra. Pero makabaton ka sang grasya ng among kalawat. That's what we call sacrament. That's why ang sacrament, pito ka sacraments, iya sang Dios aksyon sa imo kalag. Iya na aksyon gid. Hinghimuon mo lang, preserve mo lang imo faith in humility, sorrow for sins. Amo na. And then, mamba siya, ako matrapo sang higko sa guyam. Ang prayer and good works, ikaw paligo to, ikaw, imo to ya, ikaw ga paligo. Very good. Pero ang sakramento, ako mapaligo sa imo. Pahimunong lang. Tinluan ko ikaw. That's why amo na, kinanglan may sacramental life, kag may good works man kita. Pero good works and prayers are not sufficient. Kinanglan kumpletohon sang sacraments. That's why we should have a social apostolate. We should have a prayerful life and at the same time, sacramental life. Siling sa mga tao, yan, bisan din ako magsimba, maayo man buhat ko. Tunga lang na, ang buhat mo na imo na. Pero ang sakramento, iya sang Diyos ina. Sa bunyag, iya na aksyon. Sa kasal, ga take action sa Diyos kabuhi mo. Sa confession, tanawa bala. Confessar ka malang, sugid sa laa mo. Boom! Ubos na dayon, patawad din mo sa laa. Ito tanawa bala. Oh, ikaw mga budlay, penitensya mo, mabiyakusis ka pulo ka beses para mabayaran mo lang imo sa laa. Pero sa sacrament of confession, humility lang kinahanglan. Available. Available. That's why bulahan ng Katoliko kay may available sacraments. Hindi ma-appreciate sang iba na binila iya sang tao, iya sang pari. No? Iya sang Diyos. Ginestablish ni Christ. Ga-complement. Prayer, which is the upward movement of relationship. And then sacrament, which is the downward movement of our relationship. That's the way we prepare ourselves. Have a robust, healthy sacramental life, most especially the Holy Eucharist and other sacraments according or needed sang imo status sa kabuhi. Di ko mapreparar mo pagin ng iban, makabaton sang sakramento, First Communion, kasal, di ko napreparar mo dako-dako, gid nga bulig sa kalag. Sabi mo daw, ceremonias lang, dako, misyonan nato ni na. That's why gina-open kong misyon, gapanawagan ako. First Communion sa inyo kabataan because it's the action of God sa soul sang imo bata. Hindi pag-deprive ang bata mo sa lawid nga tiyempo nga hindi siya ka-communion. Do baliwala lang na sa imo. Pero ay kakabalo sang impact sina sa spiritual life sang bata. So, preparahon, mga hinablos, mga pariente, ikaw. Ikaw kung mapalmaligaan sang parents, ikaw, coordinate with parents, coordinate sa parokya para ang soul sang bata, temprano pa lang magka-communion, confirmation of God's ara sa cathedral, and most especially, kasal. So ara kita may kasal, kita dira, aksyon sang Diyos sa kabuhi. Karon kung hindi ka kapreparar, pagtabot sang kamatayon, why kay mo ya kapreparar? Why sang aksyon sang Diyos? Wala maging tagaan chan sang Diyos maghimo sang iya aksyon, himo sang iya plano sa imo kabuhi. That's why gina-imagine ko ang bata, ginapaliguan, pahimunong ka para magtinlo kagid kay ang mama sa aton Diyos, Holy Spirit, amo ang nagatinlo sa iya. Kagara ka lang, ginatawagin na nga passive. That's why sa sacrament, passive siya. Sa prayer and good works, active siya. So nag-complement sila. Hindi tanan acto, passive of course. Kailangan may good works man because faith without good works is dead. So nag-complement sila, have a prayerful life, keep your faith, hope, and love in the Lord and the love of neighbor, and most especially, healthy and productive sacramental life. Amen. Peace stand.